take a step back.
Just talk a little bit more about the choke, if you might, because there are people that still haven't mentioned talking online. Was it more of a strangle or a crank? What were you feeling from Tito's definition was coming out?
The choke that I tapped out in, so it was a rear naked choke. It was behind me. I was trying to fiddle around with his angle and I was putting pressure. And I asked him afterwards, hey, was I close on that? I don't know. I suppose I'd have to see it. I believe he had a rear naked choke.
Tito, 20 years. I'm not going to ask you about your career in context because you've done so much, but to leave the game as the game you know it now is so different from where you started. What do you feel about you, or what did you do during that 20-year period to get the sport to where it is today? How should people remember your legacy in this sport throughout context?
Well, you know, I started in this as a free, as an amateur. And I was with our fellow night, our other company, or the other company I competed with, UFC and Chris. As an amateur, I fought for no money. I fought for free. That was the beginning of my career. I fought for free. Now my friends say, you're crazy. I said, I want to compete. I want to see how good I can be in this sport. A year and a half later, I became a world champion. My kid being on the street, my parents at the time didn't want to be parents. And you look at the stuff I went through, I'm very lucky to be where I am today. It's from hard work and dedication I've been able to do this dream. Tonight was a dream. Tonight was kind of a movie. Tonight became real. When Chael was tapping, I thought that he was trying to get my hands off all that. Nothing against my heart yet. I'm trying to sign my head. But I was just holding on because I didn't think it was over. I thought it was still going. But it seemed like a movie. It's just weird. But this is the way my person's career should end. At the top of the world, how I feel right now, it's like I don't can't talk right now. I'm trying to accept it. I don't know if I want to do it. I don't know if I want to do it. It's not even giving up, I don't think. I've walked away at the right time, at the right place, and I've been respected the right way. Everybody at Bellator, everybody at Spike, Scott, you guys, this is the way it should have been when I left UFC. This is the way it should have been. But everything in this world happens for a reason. Everybody, you gotta understand. So no matter what ups, what downs you go through in life, everything happens for a reason. If that wouldn't have happened the way it happened with UFC, this would have happened tonight the way it happened tonight. And I would have rather it happen this way than it happened in 2012. Because tonight, I'm on cloud nine, my birthday's 2 days away. And I'm very, very thankful that I was able to have my son Jacob next to me to enjoy what a champion father can be. Because I sacrificed so much to give my children what they have. So much time away. People understand how much we sacrifice, how much we just suffering we do. All these other fighters, they understand. They understand the suffering we do. But the families don't understand it. The fans don't understand it. They jump from one boat to another. But at the end of the day, all we're trying to do is just feed our family. Try to give our kids what maybe we never had. I never had. I never had someone to spend my money. I slept in motels, I slept in cars, I slept in trailer parks. I don't want my children to ever see that. So over this last 20 years, I've seen sport come from only 1,500 people in the arena to over 20,000 or 17,000. Over 17,000 people in the arena. That's amazing to see. And I don't know how many viewers they got, but you've seen how Bellator has made a stamp time. We made a stamp because we made a person much fighters forward. Everybody who probably worked on that would call it heart and soul. And I gave my heart and soul out there.
Yeah, good question for Paul Daly.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekpak, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Ellie Sekpak.